Don't move! So you killed the chief, you bastard! Liquid? No, you're not. Don't move!
Is this the first time you ever pointed a gun at a person? Your hands are shaking. Can you shoot me, rookie?
Careful. I'm no rookie.
Liar. Your eyes wander. There's no confidence in them. The eyes of a rookie. You've never shot a person, have you?
You talk too much.
You haven't even taken the safety off, rookie.
I told you I'm no rookie!
You're not one of them, are you?
Open that door. You've got a card, don't you?
Why?
So we can get the hell out of here.
Looks like we'll be a little delayed. What are you doing? Don't think! Shoot! What are you waiting for? Shoot!
Don't talk to me like a rookie!
I'm telling you, shoot!
Thanks for the help.
Wait! Who are you? You fool! You've killed him!
I'm sorry, sir.
His mental shielding was very strong. I could not dive into his mind.
Now we'll never get that detonation code.
Idea.
too late? He's alive. You're the Arms Tech president, Kenneth Baker, right? Don't worry. I'm here to save you.
No! Don't touch it!
C4!
Right. Touch that wire and the C4 will blow up along with the old man. So you're the one that the boss keeps talking about.
And you?
Special Operations Foxhound. Revolver. Ocelot. I've been waiting for you, Solid Snake. Now we'll see if the man can live up to the legend. This is the greatest handgun ever made. The Colt Single Action Army. 6 bullets. More than enough to kill anything that moves. Now I'll show you why they call me Revolver. Draw!
Ah! 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 Ah!
You're pretty good. Just what I'd expect from the man with the same code as the boss. It's been a long time since I had such a good fight, but I'm just getting warmed up.
Territory. Snakes don't belong in Alaska. I will not let you pass. Send him a message. That's right. You belong on the ground. should crawl on the ground like the snake you are. Come, let's fight!
Boss, is this all right?
just giving him the card like that.
We'll play with him a little longer.
You would be wise not to underestimate him.
What did you think of him?
He is just as you said. He lives and breathes combat just like you. I would expect no less from your...
You see, I told you so, but I will kill him.
General Ivan, I hear that you lost your arm and ran away home.
Watch your tongue, Shaman.
In the language of the Sioux people, Sioux means snake. It is known as an animal to be feared.
Well, Snake is mine now. When I meet him next, I'll take special care of him. Not yet. Don't kill him yet.
He and I will meet again in battle.
Same prediction as always.
Yes, the raven on my head. It thirsts for his blood.
Stealth camouflage? Who are you?
Where is my friend?
What? What are you talking about? What next?
Snake!
Hey, you're that ninja.
I've been waiting for you, Snake.
Who are you?
Neither enemy nor friend. I am back from a world where such words are meaningless. I've removed all obstacles. Now you and I will battle to the death.
What do you want?
Oh, I've waited a long time for this day. Now I want to enjoy this moment.
What's with these guys? It's like one of my Japanese animes.
I've come from another world to battle with you.
What is it? Revenge?
It is nothing so trivial as revenge. A fight to the death with you. Only in that can my soul find respite. I will kill you, or you will kill me. It makes no difference. All right then. Watch from your box seat.
I need that man. Keep your hands off him.
Now, make me feel it. Make me feel alive again. That's a good snake. Good. Now we can fight it. remember me now.
It can't be. You were killed in Zanzibar. What? Not again!
Is it over?
Huh? I hope that's not your only trick.
You doubt my power. Now, I will show you why I am the most powerful practitioner of psychokinesis and telepathy in the world. No, there's no need for words, Snake. I am Psychomantis. That's right. This is no trick. It's true power. It's useless. I told you, I can read your every thought. You still don't believe me? I will show you my psychokinetic power. Put your controller on the floor. Put it down as flat as you can. That's good. Now, I will move your controller by the power of my will alone. It's useless.
That's Psycho Mantis, former KGB psychic. He has powerful psychokinetic and telepathic abilities. After the collapse of the Soviet Union, he came to America looking for a job. He worked with the FBI on several cases as a psychic profiler. 5 years ago, he was working on the case of a multiple serial murderer, and he got too far into the killer's mind. As a result, he became just like the killer.
So he was sort of infected by this serial murderer's thoughts?
In any case, after that he became sort of a psychic spy working for the highest bidder. He traveled all around the world. That's when he was recruited by Foxhound. He can read people's minds. He knows every move that you're going to make.
What should I do? I got no chance of beating him.
There must be some way.
He's a master at controlling people, Snake. Don't let him manipulate you. Not everything you see with your two eyes is real. Destroying his spirit is more important than destroying his body.
Don't let him read you. Be a blank slate, okay? Clear your mind. With his psychic abilities. Somehow you've got to get around him. He's using his psychic ability to read your controller's moves. That's how he's evading your attack. You've got to do something so he can't read your controller's moves. Think, there must be some way. Controller into socket 2. Do that, and he won't be able to read your moves.
Stand right where he can see you.
Your niece is going to be okay.
Thanks, Snake. I owe you one.
Now that Mantis is beaten, Meryl's brainwashing should wear off, right, Naomi?
Yes. But why did you go so far out of your way to save her? For Campbell's sake? Or maybe it's because you like her?
I don't want to see any woman die right in front of me.
Oh, really? Since when did anybody's death bother you so much?
Naomi, it's true that Snake has killed a lot of people. But that does not mean he doesn't have a heart.
It's okay, Colonel. She's right.
So, you used her there?
A strong man doesn't need to read the future. He makes his own.
Perhaps so, but I will read your future. To get to Metal Gear's underground maintenance base, you have to go through the hidden door. There's a hidden door behind the bookcase. The overland route. It's blocked by frozen glaciers. Go past the communication towers, then use the tower's walkway.
Why are you telling me this?
I can read people's minds. In my lifetime, I have read the pasts, presents, and futures of thousands upon thousands of men and women.
Oh, gross.
And each mind that I peered into was stuffed with the same single object of obsession. That selfish and atavistic desire to pass on one seed. It was enough to make me sick. Every living thing on this planet exists to mindlessly pass on their DNA. We're designed that way. And that is why there is war. But you are different. You're the same as us. We have no past, no future. We live in the moment. That's our only purpose. Humans weren't designed to bring each other happiness. From the moment we're thrown into this world, we're fated to bring each other nothing but pain and misery. The first person whose mind I dove into was my father's. I saw nothing but disgust and hatred for me in his heart. My mother died in childbirth, and he despised me for it. I thought my father was going to kill me. That's when my future disappeared. I lost my past as well. When I came to, the village was engulfed in flames.
Are you saying that you burned your village down to bury your past?
I see that you have suffered the same trauma. We are truly the same, you and I. The world is a more interesting place with people like you in it. I never agreed with the boss's revolution. His dreams of world conquest do not interest me. I just want an excuse to kill as many people as I could.
You monster.
Let him talk. He doesn't have much time left.
I've seen true evil, Snake. Seeing you calms my soul. You're like the boss. No, worse. Compared to you, I'm like a saint. I read her mind as well.
Merrill's?
I saw you there. You have a large place in her heart.
A large place?
And getting bigger. But I do not know if your futures lie together. I have a last request.
What is it?
My mask. Put it back on.
Okay.
Like this. Other people's thoughts force their way into my mind. Before I die, I want to be by myself. I want to be left alone in my own world. help someone. Strange. Such a nostalgic feeling.
Let's go, Meryl.
I'm sorry.
Meryl.
How could I let Mantis control my mind like that?
If you're going to doubt yourself, I'll leave you here.
You're right.
Don't regret your past. Learn from it. Regrets just make a person weaker.
You're right. I'm sorry. I won't do it again. Snake, can I ask you something?
More complaints?
About what Mantis said. I was just wondering...
What? What's the problem now?
Oh, no. Nothing. So tell me, Snake. What's your name? Your real name.
A name means nothing on the battlefield. After a week, no one has a name.
How old are you?
Old enough to know what death looks like.
Any family?
No, but I was raised by many people.
Is there anyone you like?
I've never been interested in anyone else's life.
So you are all alone, just like Mantis said.
Other people just complicate my life. I don't like to get involved.
You're a sad, lonely man.
Come on, let's go.
Bait to lure you out.
Damn!
Shoot me, Snake.
No.
My gun. I can't reach it but myself.
Don't move!
I promised I wouldn't slow you down. I can still help. I want to help you.
Quiet down. Save your strength.
I was a fool. I wanted to be a soldier. War is meaningless. Nothing comes out of war. Snake, please, save yourself. Go on living and don't give up on people. Don't forget me. Don't forget what I said. Now, get out of here.
Meryl!
Colonel?
Damn! Snake! It's a trap! A sniper's trick to lure you out! The sniper's waiting for you to go to help Meryl so he can pick you off! Don't do it!
It must be Sniper Wolf, Foxhound's best shooter.
Snipers usually work in pairs, but this one's alone, huh?
I know her. She can wait for hours, days, or weeks. Doesn't matter to her. She's just watching and waiting for you to expose yourself.
Maybe so, but Meryl can't hold out that long.
Snake, can you see Wolf from where you are?
There's nowhere to hide between here and the tower. She must be on the second floor of the tower.
If Wolf is in the communications tower, she can see you perfectly. It's a classic sniper's position. At that distance, you won't be able to hit her with a standard weapon either. You'll need a sniper rifle.
Colonel, take it easy. I'm going to save Meryl, no matter what it takes.
Okay. Thanks.
What's wrong, Naomi?
Don't you know? There's a tendency toward murder written in your very genes.
So saving someone else's skin is out of the question?
I wouldn't go that far, but...
I don't know what the hell my genes look like, and I don't care. I operate on instinct.
Like an animal?
I'm going to save Meryl. I don't need an excuse.
Okay.
And I'm not doing it for someone else, either. I'm going to save Meryl for myself. Colonel... Don't worry.
Snake, thanks.
I understand. I'm sorry.
We'll be right back. It's hard to miss when you're this close. Toss your weapon over here. Slowly. You're a fool to come back here. Stupid man.
A lady sniper, huh?
Don't you know that the majority of the world's great assassins are women? Do you want to die now? Or after your female friend? Which will it be?
I'll die after I kill you.
Is that right? Well, at least you've got spirit. I am Sniper Wolf, and I always kill what I aim at. You are my special prey. Got it? I've left my mark on you. I won't forget it. Until I kill you, you're all I'll think about.
Take him away!
Don't kill him yet. I want him alive.
Leave it to me.
I want no more accidents like that DARPA chief.
Yes, he's my target. Mine alone.
The snake's finally come out of his hole! Are you ready now, my brother?
Why are you calling me brother? Who the hell are you?
I'm you! I'm your shadow!
What?
Ask the father that you killed!
I'll send you to hell to meet him!
Eat this!
Snake, are you okay?
Otacon, were there any other stealth prototypes?
No, there were only five.
So, this isn't stealth camouflage then.
What are you talking about?
Someone's shooting at me, in the middle of this blizzard.
It's her!
Wolf? Sniper Wolf?
Yes, it's her! It's definitely her!
Otacon, you sound like you're happy.
No, I'm not.
So then what is it?
Snake, please don't kill her.
Are you insane?
Please. She's a good person. You'd know that if you talked to her.
That woman isn't as sweet as you think.
I can see you perfectly from here. I told you I'd never quit the hunt. Now you're mine.
Wolf! No, you can't!
Don't get between a wolf and its prey.
You're pretty good if you can hit me in this storm.
You see, women naturally make better soldiers.
Wolf, don't do this!
Snake, I'm near. Can't you sense me near you?
It's a mistake for a sniper to reveal her location.
You think so? Well, a message from me is a message from death. If I'm close, you will know death is close.
Please, Wolf! Snake! No!
Quiet! Don't get in our way!
Now I'll pay you back for Meryl.
You men are so weak. You can never finish what you start.
Ah!
I've waited for this moment. I am a sniper. Waiting is my job. Never moving a muscle. Concentrating. I am lung shot. You cannot save me. Please, just finish me quick. I am a Kurd. I have always dreamed of a peaceful place like this.
A Kurd? So that's why you're called Wolf.
I was born on a battlefield. Raised on a battlefield. Gunfire, sirens, and screams. They were my lullabies. Hunted like dogs day after day. Driven from our ragged shelters. That was my life. Each morning I'd wake up and find a few more of my family or friends dead beside me. I'd stare at the morning sun and pray to make it through the day. The governments of the world turned a blind eye to our misery. But then, he appeared. My hero, Saladin. He took me away from all that.
Saladin? You mean Big Boss?
I became a sniper. Hidden, watching everything through a rifle scope. Now I could see war not from the inside, but from the outside, as an observer. I watched the brutality, the stupidity of mankind through the scope of my rifle. I joined this group of revolutionaries to take my revenge on the world. But I have shamed myself and my people. I am no longer the wolf I was born to be. In the name of vengeance, I sold my body and my soul. Now, I am nothing more than a dog.
Wolves are noble animals. They're not like dogs. In Yupik, the word for wolf is Keglenek, and the Aleuts revere them as honorable cousins. They call mercenaries like us dogs of war. It's true, we're all for sale for some price or another. But you're different. Untamed. Solitary. You're no dog. You're a wolf.
Who are you? Are you Saladin?
Wolf, you spared Meryl's life.
Even when I'm just an onlooker, I don't like to see women or children get hurt.
Rest easy. You'll die as the proud wolf you are.
I finally understand. I wasn't waiting to kill people. I was waiting for someone to kill me. A man like you. You're a hero. Please, set me free.
Why? I loved you.
What is it?
My gun. Give it to me. She is part of me. Ah! Everyone is here now. Okay, hero. Set me free.
Goodbye. Snake, you said that love could bloom on a battlefield. But I couldn't save her. What are you doing?
Returning it to its owner. I don't need a handkerchief.
Why?
I don't have any more tears to shed. I'm going to the underground base. We're out of time.
I know.
You'll have to protect yourself now. Don't trust anyone.
Yeah.
If I can't stop Metal Gear, this whole place will be bombed to hell.
Yeah.
We might not meet again.
Don't lose the codec. I'll be behind you all the way.
You can leave anytime. Get a head start. A head start on your new life.
Snake! What was she fighting for? What am I fighting for? What are you fighting for?
If we make it through this, I'll tell you.
Okay. I'll be searching too.
Welcome, Cossack. This is the end of the road for you, right, my friends? They're becoming excited. Ravens aren't scavengers like most people think. They're simply returning to the natural world, that which is no longer needed. Sometimes, they even attack wounded foxes.
You were the one in the M1 tank? Must have been a tight fit for a big boy like you.
Ha 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 ha! But that was no true battle. The ravens and I were testing to see what kind of man you were.
The judgment is decided.
The ravens say you are a true warrior.
Am I hallucinating? I can't move.
The raven has put the mark of death upon you. Blood from the east flows within your veins. Your ancestors too were raised on the barren plains of Mongolia. Inuit and Japanese are cousins to each other. We share many ancestors, you and I.
There's no crows in my family tree.
You ready? I am not fond of snakes, but you are family, so I cannot complain. But there will be no holding back. You live in Alaska, too. You know of the World Eskimo Indian Olympics.
With that strength, you must have been training in the stick pull and four-man carry.
Yes, you are right. But there is another event that I excel at. It is called the ear pull. It's an event where two opponents pull each other's ears while enduring the harsh cold. It tests spiritual as well as physical strength.
You want to pull each other's ears?
The form is different, but the spirit is the same. Rejoice, Snake! Ours will be a glorious battle.
This isn't glorious. It's just plain killing. Violence isn't a sport.
Well, we will see if there is iron in your words. Just as the boss said, it is my existence which is no longer needed in this world. But my body will not remain in this place. My spirit and my flesh will become one with the ravens. In that way, I will return to Mother Earth who bore me. Snake! I will be watching you. Understand? Snake, take this security card. It will open that door.
Why?
You are a snake which was not created by nature. You and the boss, you are from another world. A world that I do not wish to know. Go and do battle with him. I will be watching from above. First, I'll give you a hint. The man you saw die before your eyes. That was not the DARPA chief. It was Decoy Octopus, a member of Foxhound. He was a master of disguise. He copied his subjects down to the blood. So he drained the chief's blood and took it into himself. But he wasn't able to deceive the Angel of Death.
The Angel of Death? But why go to so much trouble? Why impersonate the chief?
That is the end of my hint. You must solve the rest of the riddle yourself. An end to it, but you are different.
What are you trying to say?
The path you walk on has no end. No matter how far you go, or how many corpses you crawl over, the killing will never end. It's a future without hope. Hear me, Snake! My spirit will be watching you.
hurry! Get away!
Gray Fox!
A name from long ago. It sounds better than Deep Throat.
So it is you.
You look terrible, Snake. You haven't aged well.
I'll send you back to hell!
What do you want from me?
I'm a prisoner of death. Only you can free me.
Fox, stay out of this. What about Naomi? She's hell-bent on taking revenge for you.
Naomi.
You're the only one who can stop her.
No, I can't.
Why?
Because I'm the one who killed her parents. I was young then, and couldn't bring myself to kill her, too. Oh, I felt so bad that I decided to take her with me. I raised her like she was my own blood, to soothe my guilty conscience. Even now, she thinks of me as her brother.
Fox.
Outwardly, we may have seemed like contented brother and sister. But every time I looked into her eyes, I trembled with fear. Tell her for me. Tell her that I was the one who did it.
There you are!
We're just about out of time. Here's a final present from Deep Throat. I'll stop it from moving.
We use Royal Harriers!
Fox!
How strong is that exoskeleton of yours? Snake, are you just going to sit by and watch him die?
Is more dangerous than a jackal!
He destroyed the radome.
Impressive! You are indeed worthy of the codename Fox, but now you're finished!
Now, fire the stinger!
Fox! Can you really shoot? You'll kill him too!
front of you, I can finally die.
It's no good. I can't do it.
After Zanzibar Land, I was taken from the battle.
It's no good.
Neither truly alive, nor truly dead. An undying shadow in a world of light.
It's no good.
But soon,
I can't do it.
Soon it will finally end.
Of the government or anyone else. Fighting was the only thing I was good at. But at least I always fought for what I believed in. Snake. Farewell.
When death is entreated, the battle is decided. You see, you can't protect anyone, not even yourself. Crush you into dust! Sleeping late as usual, eh, Snake?
Liquid, you're still alive.
I won't die, as long as you still live.
Too bad. It looks like your revolution was a failure.
Just because you've destroyed Metal Gear doesn't mean I'm done fighting.
Fighting? What are you really after?
The restoration of the era when warriors such as us lived as we should.
That was Big Boss's fantasy.
It was his dying wish. When he was young, during the Cold War, the world needed men like us. We were valued then. We were desired. But things are different now. With all the liars and hypocrites running the world, war isn't what it used to be. We're losing our place in a world that no longer needs us. A world that now spurns our very existence. You should know that as well as I do. After I launch this weapon and get our $1 billion, we'll be able to bring chaos and honor back to this world gone soft. Conflict shall breed conflict. New hatreds will arise, and our own biosphere shall steadily expand.
But as long as there are people, there will always be war.
But the problem is balance. Father knew what type of a balance was best.
Is that the only reason?
Isn't that reason enough for warriors such as us?
I don't want that kind of world.
Ha! You lie! So why are you here then? Why do you continue to follow your orders while your superiors betray you? Why did you come here? Well, I'll tell you then. You enjoy all the killing, that's why.
What?
Are you denying it? Haven't you already killed most of my comrades?
That was...
I watched your face as you delivered the coup de grace. Oh, it reflected such vitality.
You're wrong!
There is a killer inside you. You don't have to deny it. We were created to be that way.
Created?
Les enfants terribles. The terrible children. That's what the project was called. It started in the 1970s. Their plan was to artificially create the most powerful soldier possible. The person that they chose as the model was a man known then as the greatest living soldier in the world.
Big Boss.
But Father was wounded in combat and already in a coma when they brought him in. So they created us from his cells. With a combination of 20th century analog cloning and the super baby method.
Super baby method?
They fertilized an egg with one of Father's cells, and then let it divide into 8 clone babies. Then they transferred the clones to someone's uterus, and later intentionally aborted 6 of the fetuses to encourage strong fetal growth. You and I were originally octuplets.
Octuplets?
Yes. The other 6 of our brothers were sacrificed to make us. We were accomplices in murder before the day we were even born. So, it was you and I, 2 fertilized eggs with exactly the same DNA. But they weren't finished yet. They used me as a guinea pig to create a phenotype in which all of the dominant genes were expressed to create you. I got all the recessive genes. You took everything from me before I was even born. But you and I aren't his only children.
What?
The genome soldiers. They too are his progeny. Carrying on his genetic legacy. But unlike us, they carry it digitally. With the completion of the Human Genome Project in the last century, the mysteries of humanity were laid bare. Thanks to Father's DNA, they were able to identify more than 60 soldier genes responsible for everything from strategic thinking to the proverbial killer instinct. Those soldier genes were transplanted, using gene therapy into the members of the Next Generation Special Forces. That's how they became the Genome Soldiers. That's right. The Genome Soldiers that you've been killing right and left are our brothers with the same genes as ours.
The Genome Soldiers?
They are misshapen creatures, artificially produced from Father's genetic pattern. They are our blood brothers, and they were born of many an ultimate sacrifice.
Sacrifices?
Human experiments.
Huh?
1991, the Gulf War. The military secretly injected soldiers with the soldier genes. The Gulf War syndrome that hundreds of thousands of returning soldiers complained about was a side effect of it.
Ha! Everyone knows that the Gulf War syndrome was caused by exposure to pesticides and radiation from depleted uranium rounds.
That was just a cover story issued by the Pentagon. First, they tried to say it was post-traumatic stress disorder, then biological weapons. The poison gas detection units and the anti-sarin injections, they were all just to cover up the secret genetic experiments.
So the so-called Gulf War babies that have been reported by Gulf War veterans are...
Yes. They, too, are our brothers and sisters.
So the Genome Soldiers mean that the experiments were a success?
Success? Don't be a fool! They're a complete failure! We're on the verge of extinction.
What?
Have you ever heard of the asymmetry theory? Nature tends to favor asymmetry. Those species which have gone extinct all show signs of symmetry. The Genome Soldiers suffer from the same problem, signs of symmetry. So do I, as do you. That's right. We are all on the verge of death at the genetic level. We don't know when or what type of disease will occur. That's why we need the old man's genetic information.
You want Big Boss's DNA so you can save your family? It's very touching.
In nature, family members don't mate with each other, and yet they help each other to survive. Do you know why? Because it increases the chances that shared genes will be transmitted to future generations. Altruism among blood relatives is a response to natural selection. That we will help our blood relatives is inscribed in our very genes.
You're telling me that your genes are ordering you to save the Genome Soldiers?
You can't fight your genes. It's fate. All living things are born for the sole purpose of passing on their parents' genes. That's why I'll follow what my genes tell me. And then, I'm going to go beyond, in order to break the curse of my heritage. And to do that, first, I will kill you. Look behind you.
Meryl? Is she alive?
I'm not sure. She was alive a few hours ago. Poor girl kept calling your name.
Meryl.
Stupid woman. Falling in love with a man who doesn't even have a name.
I have a name.
No. We have no past, no future. If we did, our fate is nothing but what is determined in the genes we inherited from our father.
Let Meryl go!
As soon as we finished our business, we're almost out of time.
You're talking about Fox dying?
No. It seems now that the Pentagon knows that Metal Gear is destroyed. They've arrived at a decision. They won't even need a BDA. If you want the details, why don't you ask your precious Colonel Campbell?
Colonel, can you hear me?
Yes, I'm listening.
What is the Pentagon trying to do? Colonel, answer me!
The Secretary of Defense has taken over active control of this operation. He's on his way there by AWACS.
What for?
To bomb the place.
What?
Not only that, B-2 bombers just lifted off from Galena Air Force Base. They're carrying B-6113 surface-piercing tactical nuclear bombs.
What? Metal Gear is destroyed. Tell the Secretary of Defense.
The Secretary of Defense heard that Naomi double-crossed us, and he's worried about Fox Die. Now that there's no more danger of a nuclear strike from Metal Gear, he's going to do whatever's necessary to cover up the truth of what really happened here.
He's going to drop a nuclear bomb to vaporize all the evidence, along with anyone who knows anything.
Don't worry, Snake. I'll stop the nuclear strike.
How?
I may be only a figurehead here, but I'm still officially in command of this mission. If I issue an order to delay the strike, it'll confuse the chain of command and at least buy you some time. It'll give you a chance to escape.
But Colonel, if you do that...
It's okay, Snake. The truth is, Foxhound was already the subject of an undercover investigation. Merrill was transferred to this base just before the terrorist attack as a way of manipulating me.
Those bastards!
I'm sorry. They forced me to cooperate in exchange for her life. You'd better get out of there, Snake.
Are you sure? It'll be bad for you.
Don't worry. It's the least I can do for you after all the lies.
Colonel.
I'm ordering them to cancel the bombing run. After that, there's no turning back.
Huh? What are you doing?
Snake!
Mei Ling, what happened to the Colonel?
I don't believe it!
What happened?
Snake, the Colonel!
Roy Campbell has been relieved of duty. This is the Secretary of Defense, Jim Houseman.
Put the Colonel back on.
He's been placed under arrest for leaking top-secret information and for the crime of high treason.
Ridiculous.
Yes, he is a ridiculous man. He truly believed that he was in command of this operation.
You bastard.
There won't be a speck of evidence left. I'm sure the President would want the same thing.
The President ordered this?
The President is a busy man. I have complete authority here.
How do you plan on explaining a nuclear attack on Alaska to the media?
Don't worry. We've prepared a convincing cover story. We'll simply say that the terrorists exploded a nuclear device.
Damn it! You'll be murdering everyone here! The scientists, the Genome Army, everyone!
Donald, the DARPA chief is already dead.
So you didn't mean to kill the DARPA chief after all?
He was my friend.
And you could care less about what happens to everybody else, huh?
Well, if you give me the optic disc, I might consider saving them.
What are you talking about?
Metal Gear's test data. Donald was supposed to bring it back.
I don't have it.
I see. Oh, well. That's okay. You two are an embarrassment from the 1970s. Our country's dirty little secret. You can't be allowed to live. You're just the lingering ghosts of a system that is no more. Well, do try to get along in the time you have left before the bomb.
Oh, there's no way out for us. Let's finish this before the airstrike. You stole everything from me. I shall nullify you and your genes, and I will take them all back. She'll make a beautiful sacrifice for our final battle. Do you see this? This will be the time limit for our final battle. When death comes for this girl, this nuclear module shall vanish from this world as well. If you win, you might still be able to save her. You could enjoy one brief moment of love before the end. And if you cross this line, you'll fall. At this height, it'll kill even you. How about you, Snake?
Meryl.
Snake? Is that you? Snake, you're alive. Thank God.
Meryl. Meryl, are you okay?
Are you okay? Is that all you can say?
Meryl, it must have been terrible.
It wasn't that bad. I didn't give in to the torture.
Torture?
And things even worse than that. I was fighting too, just like you.
You're a strong woman.
Fighting them made me feel closer to you. I felt like you were there with me. It gave me the strength to go on. But I was scared.
I'm sorry.
Don't say that. But it made me realize something. During all the pain and shame, there was one thing I was sure of. A single hope that I held on to. And that hope kept me alive. Snake, I wanted to see you again.
Meryl. That's my codec.
Snake, it's me. It looks like you stopped Rex.
Otacon, good news. Meryl's okay.
All right! You saved her, man! Good job!
I got some bad news, too. We're about to be bombed.
Oh, boy. I guess we're considered expendable.
Is there a way out of here?
A way out? Yeah. You can take the loading tunnel to the surface. There's a parking garage right next to you. The tunnel leads from there to the surface.
The door in front?
No, it's a small entrance to the west of that door.
How about the security?
I just unlocked it. Who do you think you're talking to? I'll take care of security along your escape route, too.
What are you going to do?
Me? I'll stay here.
Are you crazy?
I need a little more time to take care of your escape route.
But...
unlocking the security doors is difficult work. Only I can do it.
Otacon!
Don't worry. I'm staying here. It's my own decision.
Otacon, this is a hardened shelter, but they're going to use a surface-piercing nuclear bomb. It won't hold.
I'm through regretting the past. Life isn't all about loss, you know? Snake? I'm a complete person now. I've found a reason to live.
Good. Don't die on me.
Same to you. Take care of Meryl, okay?
I will.
Okay, I gotta go. I promise I'll do something about your escape route.
Thanks.
Thanks. Oh, that sounds nice.
I believe in you.
Thanks, Snake.
Let's get the hell out of here.
What about him? Where is Otacon?
He's fighting right now. With his old self, to be the man he wants to be.
He's fighting for us too?
Yeah, and I don't want it to be in vain.
Me too.
Snake.
Meryl. It started.
I must be heavy.
Looks like we're not gonna have a love scene after all.
Looks that way. Too bad.
Let's get out of here.
Snake, it's freezing outside. You need some clothes.
There's my sneaking suit.
Hurry up! Hurry! Looking good, Snake.
Snake. Snake!
die. If he's dead, that means...
Don't say it, Snake.
What happened to the air raid? No stealth bombers in sight.
Snake, can you hear me?
Colonel!
Are you okay?
Colonel, what happened?
The Secretary of Defense has been arrested. Early retirement.
Arrested?
I was able to get into contact with the President. Metal Gear, the training exercise, all of it. It was all the Secretary of Defense acting alone.
Acting alone? What happened to the air raid and the nuclear strike?
The orders were rescinded. The F-117s and the B-2 bombers have returned to the base. Once again, I have complete authority over this operation.
I see.
Washington isn't stupid enough to use nukes to cover up a few secrets.
I wonder about that.
In any case, the danger's over. Thanks, Snake.
Colonel, you can rest easy. Merrill's fine.
Really? Thanks. Thank you, Snake. Snake, I'm sorry I kept a lot of things from you.
It's okay, Colonel.
Snake, I'm not a colonel.
Oh, that's right.
I've got a present for you. There's a snowmobile close to you. Mei Ling saw it on the satellite photos. This time of year, the glaciers are pretty calm. You should be able to ride right out of there. I'll bet the boys at the DIA and the NSA never expected you to come home alive.
Me neither. I'd better not show my face around there.
No danger of that. You two officially died after your jeep sank into the ocean.
That's not too far from the truth.
There's also a helicopter waiting for you at the Fox Islands.
Dr. Hal Emmerich should be somewhere on the base. I want someone to bring him in.
I understand. Leave it to me.
Okay. Roy. Are you going to be okay?
Don't worry. I've got an insurance policy. A hard copy of all of Mei Ling's data. As long as I've got that, you, me, and Mei Ling will be fine.
The battery on these nanomachines will run out soon. They won't be able to follow us.
I guess we won't meet again.
Don't worry. I'll pay you a visit sometime.
Really? I'll look forward to that.
Roy, just tell me one thing.
What?
About Fox Die.
Merrill will be fine. She wasn't included in its programming.
What about me? It killed Liquid.
Naomi said she wants to talk to you face to face about that.
How is she?
Don't worry. Mei Ling's with her right now. I'm switching over to Naomi.
Snake, it's me.
Naomi?
I heard about my brother.
Fox, no, Frank wanted to tell you something. He told me to tell you to forget about him. And to go on with your own life.
Frankie said that?
Yeah. He also said he'll always love you. Naomi, your brother just saved you, me, and the whole world. He fought on sheer willpower until the very end.
Maybe now he's finally found some peace. My brother was already dying. Ever since he fought with you in Zanzibar land, He's been like a ghost. A ghost looking for a place to die.
Naomi, Liquid died from Fox Eye too. What about me? When am I going to go?
That's up to you.
What do you mean?
Everybody dies when their time's up.
Yeah, so when's mine up?
It's up to you how you use the time left to you. Live, Snake. That's all I can say to you. Each person is born with their fate written into their own genetic code, inscribed into their genes. But that's not all there is to life. I finally realized that. I told you before, the reason that I was interested in genes and DNA. Because I wanted to know who I was, where I came from. I thought that if I analyzed my DNA, I could find out who I was, who my parents were. And I thought that if I knew that, then I'd know what path I should take in life. But I was wrong. I didn't find anything. I didn't learn anything. Just like with the genome soldiers, you can input all the genetic information, but that doesn't make them into the strongest soldiers. The most we can say about DNA is that its genetic information houses a person's strengths or destiny. You mustn't allow yourself to be chained to fate, to be ruled by your genes. Humans can choose the type of life they want to live. Snake, whether you've been programmed or not isn't important. The important thing is that you choose life. And then live. Don't you think, Snake? Don't worry. I'm gonna choose life too. Until today, I've always looked for a reason to live. But from now on, I'm going to just live. Genes exist to pass down our hopes and dreams for the future through our children. Living is a link to what will come. All life is tethered to the future. Loving each other, teaching each new generation, then the world can change. I finally realized it. The true meaning of life. Thank you, Snake.
Look, I found this.
Let's keep it as a reminder.
Of what? A reminder of a successful mission? Or a reminder of the first time we met?
A reminder of how to live.
Huh?
Until today, I've lived only for myself. My survival instinct that tells me not to die. That's all the motive I've had in my life.
That's not just you. That's how everyone is.
I only felt truly alive when I was staring death in the face. I don't know. Maybe it's written into my genes.
What about now? What do your genes say about your future now?
Maybe it's time I live for someone else.
Someone else?
Yeah. Someone like you. Maybe that's the real way to live.
So, where to, Snake?
David. My name is David.
Okay, so where to, Dave?
I think it's time we look for a new path in life.
A new path?
A new purpose.
Will we find it?
We'll find it. I know we'll find it.
Hey, what are those?
Caribou. To the Aleutians, the caribou is a symbol of life. It'll be spring here soon.
For us too.
Yeah. Spring brings new life to everything. It's a time for hope. I've lived here a long time, but Alaska has never looked more beautiful. The sky, the sea, the caribou, and most of all, you.
It's nice, isn't it? Being alive.
Come on. Let's enjoy life.
You mustn't allow yourself to be chained to fate, to be ruled by your genes. Humans can choose the type of life they want to live. Snake, whether you've been programmed or not isn't important. The important thing is that you choose life, and then live.
Yes, sir. The entire unit was wiped out. Yes. Yes, sir. Thanks to the vaccine. Yes, those two are still alive. The Vector? Yes, sir. Fox Dye should become activated soon. Right on schedule. Yes, sir. I recovered all of Rex's dummy warhead data. No, there are no other records. They've all been deleted from the base's computer. No, sir. My cover is intact. Nobody knows who I really am. Yes, the DARPA chief knew my identity, but he's been disposed of. Yes. Yes. Liquid is dead. The inferior one was the winner after all. That's right. Until the very end, Liquid thought he was the inferior one. Of course, the other one thinks so, too. Yes, sir. I agree completely. It takes a well-balanced individual such as yourself to rule the world. Yes. Yes, sir. No, sir. No one knows that you were the third one, Solidus. What should I do about the woman? Yes, sir. I understand. The surveillance will continue. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Goodbye, Mr. President.